two dice are rolled, what is the probability that the sum is 7? To make sure this question is clear, a die has 6 faces, where each face is numbered from 1 through 6. To determine the probability of an event, we want to compare the favorable number of outcomes to the total number of outcomes. So to determine this probability, let's begin by determining the total number of outcomes when rolling two dice. Well, all the outcomes are listed here, so we can tell there are 36 total outcomes. Using the counting principle, we can determine this as well by considering two independent events, where we say the first event would be the outcomes from rolling the first die, and the second event would be the outcomes from rolling the second die. The product of these two ways would be the total number of ways of rolling two dice. So rolling the first die has 6 possible outcomes, and rolling the second die also has 6 possible outcomes. Notice 6 times 6 would also give us the total number of outcomes of 36. And now we'll determine the favorable number of outcomes, which should be the rolls that have a sum of 7. So looking at all of our outcomes, notice here we have a 1 and a 6, which has a sum of 7. Notice here we have a 6 and a 1, which also has a sum of 7. And these are two separate outcomes, because notice how here the first die is a 1 and the second die is a 6. Here the first die is a 6 and the second die is a 1. So these do count as two separate favorable outcomes. 2 plus 5 and 5 plus 2, as well as 3 plus 4 and 4 plus 3. So we can see there are a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 favorable outcomes, and therefore the probability of rolling two dice and having a sum of 7 equals 6/36. But we do have a common factor of 6 here. The simplified probability as a fraction would be 1/6. Now, probability can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage. So let's also show this is a decimal and a percentage. So to convert to a decimal, we divide. So 1 divided by 6. This is one reason why, if we want to be precise, we should give the probability as a fraction. Notice as a decimal, we'll have to round. If we round to 4 decimal places, the probability would be approximately 0.1667. To convert to a percentage, we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right two places and add a percent sign, which would give us 16.67%. But again, for our homework, to be precise, we should enter 1/6 as the probability. Before we go, let's talk about what this means. All probability falls somewhere in the closed interval from 0 to 1, or from 0% to 100%, where theoretically, if the probability is 0%, it's impossible for that event to occur, and theoretically, if the probability is 100%, the event is certain to occur. And of course, most probability falls somewhere in between this. Remember, our probability was 1/6, which is less than 1/4, so let's say the probability of 1/6 falls here, which means rolling two dice and having a sum of 7 is unlikely, but not impossible. Theoretically, because our probability was 1/6, this means if we roll the dice 6 times, we would expect to have a sum of 7 one time. One favorable outcome for every 6 total outcomes. I hope you found this helpful.